Thank you to everybody, and first of all to organizer and to European Commission who invited me here. And I appreciate extremely much this initiative to organize this event at the fourth time. I'm here to present to you our experience in maritime spatial planning because our institution had some project and started this field of activity 10 years ago. And also I represent here the European Maritime Spatial Planning Platform, which is a very important tools for development of this field in Europe and in the whole world. Taking into account the frame of integrated maritime policy, we can say that our institution answer to skill of marine data knowledge, maritime spatial planning, and we have here a lot of project as example. Integrated maritime surveillance being part of the Commission of Maritime Surveillance in Romania. And regarding Blue Grow and sea basin strategies, there are many steps forward to be done because we just started. And we must clarify many things. Maritime spatial planning 10 years ago being part of ICZM. During time became a solitary field, but related with other marine directives, European directives, which must be implemented. And in 2016 was elaborated the European Directive on Maritime Spatial Planning, and now our countries, Romania and Bulgaria, and I'm very happy that our colleagues from Bulgaria are here. We had traditional activities in all fields, but also in maritime spatial planning. So we started to implement since 2016 this directive in our countries, Romania and Bulgaria, in the Black Sea region. And this is extremely important things for whole region, because our experience could be shared and also transmit to the other countries, because we are here the same family. In spite of many differences, we share the same resources, the same sea, and the same conditions. During time, under this mentioned project, we developed a lot of study cases, most of them starting with plan cost project, some with national projects. And also in the last time, we had one important project, Digimare, with Bulgaria, another one under this European platform, and one dedicated totally to fisheries. I mentioned study cases, but here you can see that along our coast, we develop study cases almost along the whole coast, and also they were dedicated to different aspects very important to be resolved, just like sedimentology, ecological rehabilitation, coastal belt vulnerability, fishery and catchment impact, coastal lakes and lagoons, some defenses, hydrotechnical works, aspect of general pollution, coastal erosion, the case of one very salty lake with significance at European level for the balneary treatment mud, and some links between different lakes in Cascade, and also marine protected areas. So you can imagine that we have more than 40 years of inventory of all kind of data. I suppose that they are similar in the sea basin, because we try to standardize the data in all fields of research. But now, applying the European directives and the European rules, we must find the best equilibrium to harmonize all of this. Regarding integrated maritime policy and its components, we can say that the most important key is integration, like was declared by two important international experts, and this means the transfer and application, harmonization of international legislation to local conditions at national and regional policies and objectives, starting with the environment protection aspects, inventorying sectoral uses, and elaborated based on special information, some thematical and integrated maps. All of this goes to elaboration of plan policies, plan allocations and maps, and to elaboration of establishment of different targets and indicators. What we must remind, and it's very clear and important, is that more than 40% of people are living around the coast and are dealing with activities specific to coastal and marine areas. Our place is here between all kinds of activities. Marine research are extremely important for all fields. But what we must remind is that at general level, at global level, 2 years ago, maybe many didn't know about maritime spatial planning, but now it is such enlarged and developed this activity at the planetary level that we cannot imagine. This year in the meeting of a maritime spatial conference in Paris, in March 15, many participants from all over the world shown that they passed the important step realizing maps also from Mexico to South Korea, from Arctic region to South Africa. So in the number of initiative, Europe is in the first place, you can see here. And also in the last year, the number of spatial plan increased extremely much, and this graph shown you this. We can say that between 195 countries, 115 has economical exclusive zones, which really need to have spatial plans. Taking into account all of these components of integrated maritime policy, we can say that there are many European directives focused on the sea space. Some of them of different sectors, like tourism, fisheries, energy, navigation. But is this marine framework directive and could be one confusion, and the key is to know very well all of them and to avoid overlaying. Regarding marine data and knowledge, we can say that the research activity and project developed started to prepare maritime spatial planning databases, and there are in work the database center and sites dedicated to this field. In Romania, there are nominated national authorities and the National Committee for Maritime Spatial Planning, and we had a previous experience in regarding legislation and the National Committee of ICZM, which work in our country at a Black Sea level, and also in Bulgaria. What I say is also real in Bulgaria, because we developed together a common project who supported the national authorities to elaborate legislation, to elaborate indicators, methodology, and also we are instead on preparing visions, strategies, and transboundary approach, which are extremely important between Shabla and Mangalia, which will have some scenarios, and in this way we are in a trend of European developed countries level, but and we are an example for the Black Sea. For sure, we are part of the integrated Maritime Surveillance Commission, and also a member of this European platform. And we developed under the Mars Plan project study cases in different fields, extremely important, like fisheries and aquaculture, like land sea interaction, coastal erosion, transboundary approach, as I told you, meetings with stakeholders, and also navigation. European platform must be known by everybody. It is a source of information about this field in all ways and for all countries in the world. He provides services with collected information and have information about all seabass in all countries in the world, about all maritime spatial planning projects, trainings, competitions, studies, and so on. And this platform could give assistance, could help for develop maritime spatial planning in each country, to provide help in organizing workshops, and so on. And here I mention the addresses where you can be contacted. And I must mention that Romania and my institute in Constanța, and Bulgaria, one institution in Sofia under ECORIS organization, are maritime spatial planning focal points for the Black Sea. Now I will say some words about our project. Even each of them could be subject of one presentation, but is not time for this. So this assistance for maritime spatial planning platform, it's a very interesting and huge work. A Mars Plan project supported the implementation of directive in Romania and developed in both countries, Romania and Bulgaria, the same system of methodologies. And the last aim is to can elaborate one common spatial plan and to identify everything is in the cost. And for this, we developed study case mentioned, but also one very big study regarding the environmental condition and regarding every activity is developed in the Bulgarian and Romanian marine space, identifying also the gaps in knowledge. And we prepare for this long summary of database to be identified. Under European platform, it is in trend to, and I mentioned for the first time, the elaboration of a handbook guidelines regarding vision in maritime spatial planning to support a sustainable blue economy. It will be presented at the Conference of Blue Grow in Brussels in October 11-12 this year. And this handbook will have mentioned in details all steps of elaborating of vision in each country in relation and based on the other component of maritime spatial planning strategy, roadmap, action plans, different scenarios resulted after discussion with all kind of stakeholder and social or professional groups living on the coast and on the sea, and also aspect related forecasts. Also, the same team elaborated the maritime spatial planning indicators, helping the Blue Grow. After a very huge work and elaborating different kind of frameworks, they were established main step of the process of indicators, developing indicators related with methodology and database, and also the main structural components regarding outputs, outcomes, impacts on indicators. I must mention that under the MASPLAN project, we also proposed Romania and Bulgaria our own indicators in other way that were worked on the platform, starting from the indicator for biodiversity, indicators for fisheries, indicators for environmental aspect, economical, political indicators, and at least we have the same result, but the way in which this team of the platform proposed indicators are more synthetic, and I gave here some examples regarding wind energy, aquaculture, fisheries. Regarding marine data and knowledge, we must say that we tried to identify all kind of information regarding marine space. But here it's a synthesis, and I suppose it is very well done. Our chapters being too many, and they are focused on ecological aspect, aspect of industrial activities, aspect of local communities, of activities on the sea, and people which are employing this. International legislation, relevant project, many aspect related pressures, and also relation between different activities to see if they are positive or negative, and to try to avoid negative things. Regarding the other project related to maritime spatial planning and fisheries, we should mention that at the Black Sea level, we apply for the first time very new methodologies which help us to identify in temporal and spatial way relation with fisheries, with other activities from marine space, and also to install on map each point of each vessel action, depending of number of fishing tools, depending of this, depending of species of fish which are fished, and also this kind of approach could be functioning by some system of matrix, by grid and displays methodologies. And also for the first time, we evaluated the ecological footprint of fish farming, which are focused on the seabed. And we have the possibility to prepare maps for the bottom of the sea. And it is at the international level, it is a very important issue, because the activity of aquaculture using so many fertilizer and also feeding products for fish produce much pollution on the environment. We didn't forget about stakeholders, and because of this we had some important study cases on stakeholder meetings which are tested after discussion and information are processed, and where involve many partners from Romania and also in Bulgaria. Our colleagues had meetings with coastal communities from the transboundary area. And we elaborated a lot of kind of maps. I mentioned some thematical, some integrated based on these methodologies mentioned. And we started to resolve some problems because all of them has practical application. To know where are concentrated fishing stocks, or to know how to resolve the problem of coastal erosions, and also this aspect of coastal habitats and marine protected areas are extremely important. Down on page there are two maps, Romania-Bulgarian coast, regarding the energy activities. And for the first time were elaborated some fact sheets. Here are one related shipping covering all Europe. This fact sheet mentioning the most important things related each kind of marine activities. For example, shipping is supported by ports, shipbuildings, ship repairs. And there are counted different parameters regarding jobs, productivity, some temporal, spatial characteristics.
Time, please, can you,
yes.
Can
and
you
also for Romania, we had a detailed study regarding shipping and ports, port activities, port infrastructure, connection, shipping routes, port traffic, shipping flows, related Danube, related Black Sea countries, and also port infrastructure and navigation line. And for shipping routes, we are included in all Black Sea countries line of navigation. And we also evaluated the pressure of navigation on marine environment, starting with physical effects, chemical effects, and solution for improvement. Also, some of the technical works were done on the coast because they affect the sea, and they are related channel of the Sulina branch of Danube Delta, different aspect of sensitivity of coastal belts, and some aspect regarding marine ports. Thank you for your attention, and excuse me.